I could not see the train, but I knew it must be close now. And this, the last few minutes of waiting, this was the hardest time of all. All around me were other Italians. All around me I saw excited faces, heard excited voices. I was excited too. But after 2 years without seeing my wife and child, after 2 years in a strange country, being lonely, working hard, and saving every penny for this moment, is not a man entitled to be excited? So big. How are you suddenly so big, eh?
2 years are not so suddenly.
Papa, Mama was seasick on the boat.
Oh, no. Well, just a little.
So, seasick. I was sick on the boat myself. Come, let's go home.
Home?
Home.
This new world, every sound, every sight, so strange. I was happy to be with Mario again, but in my heart I was afraid and lonesome for all the things I had left behind. Let's go home, Mario had said. Sunny Italy was home for me. This cold gray building, would this ever be home? Fear was growing in me and loneliness, but I must try not to be afraid, for Mario's sake.
Where do you see the apartment? Where do you see the stove, I thought, the refrigerator? I don't know, maybe you won't like it.
How can I tell before I see?
Maybe you think it's not clean enough. I meant to sweep a little, but I only left the rooming house yesterday.
Papa, open the door.
Yes, Papa, open the door.
A key. Where did I put the key?
Oh, a fine thing. I come all the way to Canada and you lock me out of my own house. What kind of a man?
The
first neighbor walked right by without even a look. I felt cold and lost. And so different a new place, so bare. And like the man who passed me on the stairs, so unfriendly.
Mama, look, a radio!
It doesn't work, Silvio.
Oh.
Oh, maybe we can get it fixed.
Can we, Papa?
Maybe. Will you like it?
It is very nice.
You better see the kitchen. Come on, you better see the kitchen right now.
Oh, it is beautiful. So beautiful.
This is more like it, eh?
Oh, Mario, there's no food.
I meant to get some, but...
Oh, you waited for me, eh?
What does a man know about buying food? I've waited 2 years for you to cook dinner for me.
Mario.
It's so good to have you here. You don't know how it's been without you.
I know.
Mama, I'm hungry.
I think we better go and buy some food. He had nothing to eat since this morning.
And there's a store in the corner. You'll be able to buy everything you need.
Mario can't go there alone. You come with me, won't you? Please come with me.
Of course I'll come with you. Both your men will come with you. How you like it?
It's big.
Big. Nothing to compare with it in Lesotho. You could take 50 senior Picheri's grocery stores, put them in here, they would be lost.
It is big, Mario, very big. Too much happened too fast here. So new, such different people. I was so far away from home and I couldn't understand anything.
Mama, look at this, Mama!
Sylvia, come here at once!
Yeah, so what's wrong? He was doing no harm.
I know.
What is it? What's wrong?
Oh, I don't know, Maria. I'm suddenly so afraid. Everything is so cold here and strange. People, the way they look at me. I'm so afraid, Maria.
You'll be all right. Everything is new now. It's strange. It'll be all right. You wait and see. Come on, let's hurry up. We'll have a big fest at dinner, a celebration. Hey, everything will be all right. You wait and see. Come on.
See my gun? What's your name? Can't you talk? My name's Barry. What's yours? Look, me, Barry. Barry, that's my name.
Barry?
Yeah, that's it. Now, what's your name?
Me, Silvio.
Okay, Silvio, shake. Say, I know this is a swell cave. Nobody else knows about it, only me. I'll take you to it. Wanna go? Now look, you want to come with me? Okay, come on.
Thank you.
I can't help it, Mario. My coffee pot and my dishes.
You should be glad they're here at last.
I am, Mario, I am.
Then why the tears, huh?
Because I'm so glad to have them.
Women. Who can understand how their minds operate?
Oh, my coffee pot. They're not made by machine like the ones here. And made, fashioned by an artist in Firenze. When I look at my coffee pot, it's just like having a little of my home with me again.
This is your home now, Luisa. Our home.
I remember you coming home from work and I would make dinner for you and afterward I would make coffee. And we would sit and look out in the evening.
I remember how tired I was each day after I came home from work. So tired I could hardly stand. And another day just like it to look forward to.
Sometimes some friend would come in and we would sit and talk, drink wine and laugh.
All the time, work, work, work. For what? For a few lire that was never enough even to buy enough food and clothes for my family. For the knowledge that I was born the son of a laborer and the fear that my own son would be the same as me.
Do you remember the feste? Music in the piazza, laughter, people singing, and there was always sunlight and the sky deep blue. In Italy.
Italy. Listen, Luisa. In Italy, I was nothing. Nothing. And always afraid. Afraid because I could never make enough money to put some aside. And if anything should happen to me, boom. Here I work hard. The first year, harder even than in Italy, digging ditches. But now I drive a truck. And someday maybe I won't even have to drive a truck.
You are very happy here, Mario, aren't you?
Happy? Sure, I'm happy. Why shouldn't I be happy? Aren't you? Aren't you, Luisa?
I am very happy to be with you, Mario. That all that matters to me. Well, and now you finish to unpack the dishes and I go make some coffee. The kind of coffee we had in Italy, eh?
Getting a little warmer, don't you think? You're new in the building, aren't you? I told Harry, that's my husband. I thought there was a new family in the building, but I just wasn't sure. Maybe we could have a cup of tea one of these afternoons.
I can't understand. Is she angry with me?
I'm not one for talking over the back fence.
What is she saying?
Moves in, it's nice to make a call. Well, that's the way you feel about it. I was only trying to be friendly.
I know, understand.
Thank you.
Signora.
Buongiorno, Padre.
If there is something I can do to help?
Thank you, Father. Nothing.
Perhaps.
It is nothing, Father. Nothing at all.
Tears are usually for something. You are new in Canada?
This Saturday it will be 2 weeks since we come.
We? Your husband and you?
My son, Mario, my husband, has been here for 2 years.
Quite a difference between 2 weeks and 2 years. But differences have a way of disappearing, you know.
I hate this country. I hate everything about it. The people, the ugly buildings, the gray sky. I hate every part of it. Oh, forgive me, Father, I shouldn't have said that.
You spoke what you felt. It is not easy to come to a new country.
People are so strange. I cannot understand any one of them. I'm so afraid, Father. Every minute of the day, I'm afraid.
Time. You must give it time, Signora. In time, many things happen. You'll make friends.
Friends? How can you make friends in such a country with such people? Oh, I'm sorry, But in Italy, in the town where we lived, we know every person in the street. If a family is happy, we are happy too. If there is a wedding or a baby is born, we are all happy. When a family is sad, we are sad too. Here, nobody cares if you are happy or sad. There is a man, he lives in the same building where we live. A dozen of times we have passed each other in the stair. He does not speak a word, just walks by with that cold Canadian look.
Perhaps, Signora, you can find companionship with the Italians. There are many living here now, you know.
Yes, I know. Last week I met a woman, a cousin of a man in our town. On Sunday after Mass we met, talked. All she had to speak about was about the fine house she has and how much money her husband makes.
Fortunately, Signora, such people are exceptions. But it proves one thing, that on occasion even Italians can be insensitive.
If that is true, it is because this country makes them so. Well, thank you for listening, Father. I have to go home now because my son is coming home from school.
Listen, Signora, I told you, it is not an easy thing to come to a new country. I know everything is very strange for you.
And will it ever not be so? Will it?
I'm afraid part of the answer to that depends on you.
That you don't run to the front door the minute you hear my foot on the stairs, huh?
Oh, Mario.
Crazy. Maybe I'm crazy. I just had a wonderful idea.
Whoa. You are crazy. Well, what's the wonderful idea?
Are you still to read this newspaper? You must know every word by heart now.
But there won't be another one from Italy until next week.
That's right, there won't. Hey, where's Silvio?
Oh, playing outside.
Luisa, I thought of it today while I was driving the truck. Maybe in a few months we could bring your father over here. What do you think?
No, Mario.
Well, why not? It wouldn't be easy. But 2 or 3 months, we have enough paid off so we could get another loan from the Immigrant Aid Society.
I don't want my father over here.
Why not, Louise? Why not?
Because he would be just as miserable as I am. Oh, I'm sorry, Maria. I shouldn't have said that.
But you mean it?
Yes, I mean it.
The whole 2 years. Working, living in rooming houses. I dreamed of the time when you and Silvio would be here. How good it would be, the three of us together. And later, when the old folks came.
Mario.
Listen, Louisa, I've watched your unhappiness since you come here. I said nothing, because I knew how you felt. I thought, give her time. Give her time to get settled, a few weeks, a few months even. I thought you're strange here. But you're not even trying to get settled, Louisa. You're not even trying. You think you're the only one who ever missed Italy? You think you're the only one whose heart ever ached? Listen, when I first came here, when I felt myself alone in a strange place with no friends, I cried at night. Almost every night I cried. Does that surprise you? I missed Italy too. I missed the air, the grass, the mountains. I missed everything about it. I try to tell this to somebody and they say, you don't like it here? Why don't you go back where you come from?
Ari, you're hurting me.
How many times I would have given my right arm just to be back in an Italian town? Any Italian town. Just to see the dust in the streets. To hear the kids yelling. The men arguing in the trattoria. There are times, even now, when I still give my right arm to be back in Italy.
Then why do we have to stay here? Why do we have to talk about bringing my parents over? Why don't we just take them on and go back to Italy where we belong?
Because this is where I belong now, Louisa. I fought for a new life here and now it's begun. Can't you understand that? This is my home now. Our home. This is where I want Silvio to grow up. And after we have other kids, I want them to grow up here too.
How can you want a thing like that for our children? How can you expect them to grow up without any friends, without anybody to talk to?
In here, Silvio.
Mama, can I go over to Paris and watch TV? He wants me to come.
Sure, you can go.
Okay.
But don't be late for dinner.
Paris wants me to eat with them. His mother said I could. Can I, Mama?
Oh, all right. But be sure you come right home afterward, eh?
Okay, see you later.
See you later.
If I would know it is impossible, I would think it was you who did that. Oh, Mario, I'm not doing very well now, making you unhappy. I wish I could do something about it.
You will. And it's going to take time. Vitese, Mario Vitese.
I'm Helen Austin.
Pleased to meet you.
Are you Italian, Mr. Vitese?
Si, that's right, I am.
I thought so. I heard you and your wife talking one day, and I told Harry, that's my husband. Hello, Mr. Craig. Grumpy old devil. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, I told Harry I thought you were Italian. Your wife, she doesn't understand very well, does she?
No, not yet. She's only been here 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Well, no wonder. You know, Mr. Vitese, I saw Mrs. Vitese out back one day last week, and I was chattering away to her. I didn't know she couldn't understand me, and when she didn't answer me, I thought she was being, well, snooty.
Oh, no, not Louisa. She's real nice.
I'm sure she is. After I heard you two talking together, I was sure she didn't understand me. I told Harry I didn't think she did, and he said I should go see her.
Well, she'd like that. She's alone all day.
Well, I meant to, but to tell you the truth, Mr. Vitese, I was afraid to.
A friend of Louisa?
Oh, I know it sounds silly, but I didn't know how we'd talk to each other.
Ciao, Mario.
Oh, Louisa. This is Mrs. Ogden.
Hello, my dear.
Oh. Louisa! I'm sorry. She's afraid, too.
Sure. Mr. Vitesse, would you and your wife come over and see us some night? My husband, Harry, he's a machinist, and some weeks he works on the night shift. But this week he's on days. How about tomorrow night?
Well, if you come visit us too sometime.
Sure we will. And thanks for carrying my groceries. Okay. I'll take them now. And we'll be seeing you.
All right. Thank you.
She's gone?
Louise, why? Why?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mario. But when I saw her in a yard last week, she was talking to me and I couldn't understand. And when I saw her out here now, I was scared.
Well, you shouldn't be scared. She and her husband are coming to see us.
They're coming to see us in our apartment?
Well, that's what she said.
Oh, Mario. You will have to go out right away and get another bottle of wine and some sugar and some eggs so I can make a cake. And I need a...
Louise, they're not coming tonight.
Oh. But when?
Soon. But first we're going to their place, tomorrow.
We are going there tomorrow?
She asked if we would.
But what am I going to wear? We have to get all dressed up.
Louisa, it's only across the hall.
But Mario, I can't wear these. I know I wear the dress I made especially for coming to Canada. Oh, Mario, I hope they're going to like us.